Welcome back, Robin here, and in this second chapter of my video series, whose playlist you can find up here, I'm excited to explore an awesome new feature, Enhanced Light and Color. This tool leverages a powerful machine learning model and has been added to the recently introduced Color Adjustments filter, which you can also find on Final Cut Pro for iPad. Okay, so I have a project here with a drone shot that I think is a little too dark, and it also has somewhat of a bluish color cast. To correct this in one fell swoop, I can apply the new machine learning enhanced color adjustments filter. As usual, you have several very easy ways of going about it. Maybe the most obvious would be to go to the filters browser and to the color category and either drag the color adjustments filter from here to the clip, or if the clip is selected, simply double click it. And as usual, it appears in my effects list. I'll undo. You could also just go into the color inspector and select the color adjustments filter from the menu of color correction options at the top, assuming you don't have it set as your default, which will only actually apply it to the clip if I change something. I'll undo. Last but not least, you can go into the color correction and audio enhancement menu under the viewer and select the new Enhance Light and Color menu item, or hit Control Option Command O. Whereby the notable difference between the three options is that only if I apply it from the menu or via the shortcut, the color adjustment filter is applied and the clip is quickly analyzed and the new enhanced light and color analysis is activated for all parameters. With any of the other two methods, the enhancement needs to be activated manually. Without it active, the filter behaves just as in previous versions. Each section has a little magic wand button to activate or deactivate the analysis for the entire section. One for light, one for color. Once activated, it uses machine learning to analyze the current frame and automatically optimize the tonal range of the image with the light section, as well as remove any visible color casts with the color section. Making any manual adjustments also automatically deactivates the overall enhancement, as well as the enhancement for whichever section you change. As I mentioned, one thing to keep in mind is the analysis, or rather the resulting settings for the individual parameters, are always determined based on the current image. For example, if I delete it one more time and go to the first frame, again we can see it is a bit dark and also has a slight blue color cast. To help me judge the results better, I can first hit Command 7 to open the scopes. I'll set it to a 2 up with the scope on top for saturation and the RGB parade on the bottom for judging the luminance. In addition to that, for additional visual feedback in the viewer itself, I'll go into the viewer's view menu and towards the bottom to activate the range check for both luma and saturation. Now I'll simply apply the enhanced light and color with Control Option Command O. We see it do a short analysis, and there we go. The image's dynamic range is improved, and the color cast is pretty much neutralized. After applying it, I can make further manual adjustments using the color adjustment effect. For example, I can deactivate the light or color section separately to exclude these parameters from the analysis, or I can adjust the parameters in each section individually. By deactivating the analysis with the little magic wand button for each section individually, I can see the effect of each. Deactivating the light section makes the image darker again. Deactivating the color section brings the blue color cast back. Overall, with both active, I'm at a minimum given a great starting point for further improvements. Looking at the individual values, I can see what the analysis found needed to be improved the most. In the light section, exposure, brightness. In the color section, the highlights warmth is obviously the biggest issue. These also give me a great indicator as to what I need to adjust if I want to improve it in the same direction that much more or less. So if I look at the scopes and think it could use a little more brightening up, I can use the exposure and brightness sliders to push things further to 100% IRE, all the while paying attention to my viewer as well, to be sure I don't overexpose any areas that are indicated by the zebra pattern that appears in the clouds, for example. And if I think it's still too blue, I can adjust the warmth for the highlights or even the midtones and shadows, maybe even the overall saturation, depending on which baseline correction or seasonal look I'm going for. Once I'm happy, I can turn the filter on and off to see its effect. Looks Pretty good, if you ask me. And again, I think this is a superb tool, especially for people who are not overly versed in the minutiae of color correction. I can imagine many more people can much more easily and quickly get the correction they are looking for. Okay, so now I've corrected the first frame to my liking. But as I said before, both this analysis as well as overall correction only apply to the current frame. So what happens if I skim through the rest of the clip? Only a few seconds later in the clip, I can see by the zebra pattern that appears that the exposure is too high for this portion of the clip as well as later on. Nothing unusual if you're not working with auto exposure. So I basically have two options. I can look for the brightest part of the clip and activate the enhancement for everything, or just for the light section, assuming I like the results, or simply manually re-expose to that frame. Of course, going back to the first frame, I can see that that darkens this part of the clip. But if I'm just looking for a general baseline correction for the entire clip, I could leave it at that. But I want consistent exposure across the entire clip, so I'll undo that. Now, to maintain my initial correction, I'll simply set a keyframe at the very first frame at the top of the color inspector, and then skim to the point just before the sky starts overexposing. Here, I'll set another keyframe, and then skim a little further to where it's even more overexposed. Now I can simply adjust the parameters such as exposure, brightness, and black point to my liking until the zebra pattern from the range check disappears, which automatically creates an additional keyframe. But only for the parameters that I adjust, by the way. I can repeat this for every time I see the zebra pattern sneak back into the image. Once finished, if I skim through the entire clip, I can see that I now have much more consistent exposure levels across the entire clip. I can even watch the parameter values change as I move along the clip. Really nice and very simple. With a consistent baseline correction established, I can now apply additional color correction filters to refine and enhance any specific look I'm aiming for, such as the color wheels, curves, or any of the 12 new presets for color correction filters introduced in version 10.8, which are available for Final Cut on iPad 2, by the way, once again enabling seamless color correction across devices. And by the way, should you not already know, you can set the color adjustments or any of the other four color filters, for that matter, as your default. You simply go into the Final Cut settings with Command Comma, and here, under the General tab at the bottom, you can choose whatever color correction filter you prefer the most. If I set this to Color Adjustment and close the Settings window, now, if I don't already have another color correction filter applied, every time I hit Command 6 to open the Color Inspector, whichever filter I set as my default is the one that shows up in the window, ready for me to make adjustments. Oh, and not to forget, these same machine learning enhancements are also available in Motion's version of the Color Adjustments filter. Simply apply it from the Filters menu or Filters library and activate and adjust it just as you would in Final Cut Pro. So, do you think the balanced color effect can be retired? Is this new feature more useful for you than the usual more cryptic wheel and curve-based corrections? Give it a shot and let us know how it works for you and what you think down in the comments. If you enjoyed the video and learned something new, maybe help the channel by giving it a like or even subscribing. And if you're interested in other great changes and features, check out the playlist or one of these related videos. Hope to see you there or in the next one. Thank you for watching and take care.